is the day that we celebrate Memorial Day, right? Now, for some of you, it's a much-needed and perhaps long-waited for a three-day weekend. You know, it's a time that we break out the grills and we get them fired up. We open up the pools. We get together with our friends and family on Memorial Day, and we might call it the beginning of summer. And maybe some of you are in that mindset, right? And it's a good thing. Enjoy it. And as exciting as all of that is, as Memorial Day is, you know, it is much bigger than our barbecues tomorrow, right? The day that you will enjoy off. It's much bigger than summer beginning and headed to the beach or the pool. It's much bigger than that, right? Memorial Day, as we saw in the video, it marks truly a day of sacrifice. Let it be. That's good. I'm glad to hear the amens and the yeses. That's good. Because Memorial Day, it's a day of sacrifice. Memorial Day, it's a day to remember those who paid the ultimate price for our nation. That is what Memorial Day is, everybody. And we remember those who have given and sacrificed their lives. And, you know, Memorial Day, it's not a pleasant day for everybody. For those who have been involved with families who have paid the ultimate price, it's a hard day. Might be an overwhelming day. It might not be the day that they go to the beach or they have their barbecues. But they paid the ultimate sacrifice. Amen. So let us remember what the day is. And we do honor those who have served in the military. We honor our soldiers. We honor those who have given up their lives for something greater than themselves. We will always honor that in the church house, because the church house, one of the fundamental beliefs of the church house is sacrifice. And you know the scriptures that say, greater love has no one than this. What is that? And to lay down his life for his friends. Amen. So we will enjoy our days. We will live our lives and fulfill our dreams because of those who didn't fulfill their dreams, and for those who laid down their lives, for those who truly sacrificed. But I do believe the way we honor their sacrifice is to live for what they died for and chase your dreams and fulfill them. Live your lives and let them be large. And I think we said it in our prayer time this morning, let freedom ring, everybody. So today in the church house, maybe we should talk just a moment about sacrifice, if that's all right, sacrifice. And God's Memorial Day. Because sacrifice, when I look at it on a day like today, it's a day truly that's wrapped in the flag, amen? It's definitely wrapped in that beautiful flag. Amen, somebody? Amen. Sacrifice, it's a word that's wrapped with integrity, love, honor. So much is built upon sacrifice. Amen, everybody? Amen. You can't build great lives. You can't build a great nation. You can't build a great family without sacrifice. It is absolutely fundamental to life. Fundamental, not for just the Christian life, to life. You know, a lot of times I don't see a dividing line between Christian life and life. I just see life, the life of God. So, you know, maybe we can turn to a passage and think about sacrifice today for a moment and define it in certain terms. I think I'd like to do that. Would you like to do that? Before we take off and enjoy the rest of the three-day weekend, is that all right? All right, thank you. God bless you, sister. If you have a Bible and you still like to bring them to church and open them up, you know what to do, the Gospel of Luke. I'm going to time you all. You ready? Let's see. The first one to get it, raise your hand. Except for, I knew Pastor Bill was going to raise his hand. I know. Show off. This is the Lottie. All right. This is the Lottie. Good. The rest of us are going to have to wait for Brother Keith. Luke chapter 22. Brother Keith, when you get it, you raise your hand. Hey. All right, I'll turn it into. You know, Luke 22. Now, in Luke 22, this, of course, is going to speak about the ultimate sacrifice, the greatest sacrifice man has ever known. And it is the sacrifice of God sending his son, amen, the man, Jesus Christ, to die for the world. So when Jesus is about to experience his last meal with his friends, who he's about to die for upon earth, this is the passage. In verse 14, he says this, when the hour finally came and Jesus and his apostles reclined at the table, and he said to them, he said this, Jesus said to his friends, I have eagerly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I tell you, I will not eat it again until it finds fulfillment in the kingdom of God. I love these passages, today being our Communion Sunday, everybody. Today is Communion Sunday. Therefore, Jesus Christ himself, after taking the cup, this is beautiful. Jesus Christ himself, he gave thanks and said, take this and divide it among you. For I tell you, I will not drink again of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes. And then Jesus Christ himself, he took the bread, he gave thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to them saying, you want to read with me? This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Let's do one more verse together, guys. I like that. Verse 20. You ready? In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is poured out for you. Beautiful. The word of the Lord, everybody. Maybe we can just pause for a moment on this Memorial Day weekend, okay? And maybe just describe or define or figure out what is sacrifice and the absolute importance of it. The need for it, and how greatness is built upon sacrifice, everybody. Is that okay? You guys mature enough for this kind of a word? Is that okay to give back a little bit? You know, the first thing I see when I read this passage here, it says that very simply, you know, if you want to define sacrifice and what the sacrifice looked like, I found the one to be real simple, almost whimsical, but absolutely true. Sometimes sacrifice is very simply a meal together. A meal together. Isn't that something that Jesus, with his 12 disciples, his family, he said, I have desired greatly to have a meal with you. Now, I think perhaps most of the folks that can relate to this, maybe parents or grandparents perhaps can relate to this really well. Got to get an amen from some of the parents. You know, when your children maybe start to grow up and have their own way, or maybe, you know, things start to cause the family to go in different ways. I've heard it said from parents and grandparents, I just want to have a meal with my son or my daughter. And if they were just lucky enough, they'd have their whole family together. Isn't that something? Isn't that true? Can you see true life in that with Jesus? Jesus says, I have greatly desired to have a meal with you. And by definition, according to our word today, that's sacrifice. Sometimes sacrifice is having a meal, right? Can't you sacrifice just to sit down and have a meal with the family? I mean, I know how busy you are. And even a day as today, Communion Sunday, some of you may stay. I hope all of you stay. What sacrifice? Can you have a meal with us? Can you have a meal with us? Isn't that something? I love that. I love the simplicity of it. Because you lay down your life. There's power in that. There's power in having a meal together, everybody. There's power in that. And you know, sometimes it takes a while to learn that with our busy schedules. We'd say to have lunch, I just don't got time. Life is about having meals together, not making a few more dollars. But you know, moving on, the second thing that I see and how I want to define sacrifice, I guess, why don't you look back down at verse 17, and it says this. It says, after taking the cup, he gave thanks and said, take this and divide it among you. What I love about this in regard to the cup is, he said, take this and divide it among you. Jesus Christ took his life, and he said, hey, divide my life amongst yourselves. Isn't that something? Isn't that powerful? You know, when I think about the sacrifices, of course, the sacrifices of our men and our women and really what the day is all about, the soldiers who have given their lives. But they say, and they follow the example of Jesus Christ, where he said, Jesus Christ took his life and he said, just divide it amongst yourselves. And he said, there's enough for every one of you. Every one of you gets a piece. I guarantee you that peace that you get from him will overwhelm you. Amen. That peace that you get from him will love you all of the days of your life. Amen. He will watch over you and protect you. The peace that you get from him, he'll give you identity and purpose, a reason to get up in the morning. Jesus says, my life, and I want you, eventually we're going to take this and turn it back on yourself. He says, my life is too large. Jesus Christ said, my life is too large for me to live alone. I got to let others live it too. Jesus said, I've been blessed, and maybe one day we'll say we've been blessed, and just take your life and divide it and give it to everybody around you. Wow. Look what they did with that. Look what they did with that. They changed the world with that. So can you. But I want you to know that's how precious and how loved each and every one of you. Every one of you he gave a piece of his life to. Verse 19, I see another understanding of what sacrifice might be. Verse 19 says this. It says, this is extraordinary. It says, what does it say, everybody? Verse 19. It says, he took the bread, gave thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to them. Let's pause there. Let's see, there's several things there. I think it's extraordinary that Jesus Christ, he's not just doing these things as an example, it's his true heart. Jesus Christ gave thanks. He gave thanks for what he had. There are two accounts in the Bible that talk about Jesus feeding the multitudes. Have you ever read either one of them? Okay, it seems like only like six of you have read it. I fell on a dead note there. There's a couple of stories, and you better nod your head, or we're going to go back and read them all. But there's a couple of stories in the Bible where it says that Jesus was speaking to the multitudes, and Jesus had some big crowds, you know that? You know, some say 15, 20,000 people. And then, you know, he was there all day, and you know how it went. Jesus would say, you know, we can't send him home without feeding him. What was the one story? Wasn't it like one boy that brought lunch that day? How come out of 20,000 people, one boy brought lunch? Anyway, that's not the topic, but anyway. One boy brought lunch. And I don't know, two loaves, five fishes. There's different stories, and then there's different accounts of how much was there. But it seemed like there was not enough. Absolutely, you know, two loaves and five fish, it cannot feed 20,000 people. Amen. So they did not have enough, seemingly did not have enough. So Jesus took that substance that was not enough, he took that thing that was not enough, and what did he do with that thing that was not enough? What did he do with the substance in his hands that was not enough? No. He gave thanks. He thanked God for what was not enough. And turned it into something that was more than enough. And you know, sometimes sacrifice, it's the sacrifice of our lips for sure, but I think there's dynamic, powerful spiritual truths that can transform your lives if you really want it, because not everybody wants it. You just cry that you want it, but you really don't want it. You just like crying. Truth. So if you just like crying, just keep on crying. But if you want your cry to be answered, if you really want your cry to be answered, then thank God for what you do have. Because I know you want to spend all day complaining about what you don't have. I don't have enough money. I don't have enough time. I don't have enough strength. I don't have enough love. I don't have enough joy. I don't have happiness. I don't have enough relationships. And God says, okay, then you'll never have enough. And I believe sacrifice and part of that, and I think this is life transforming. You thank God for what you do have. Thank God for what you do have. Seems like the whole world is against me today, but that one person gave me a smile today. Go thank God for that smile. Thank God for the angel that he sent to say hello to you. I know you missed out on 10, but one came. Thank God for the one. Thank God for the little. There's spiritual truth here. And God will turn it around. Well, you have more than enough. Is that extraordinary to you? Yes. Jesus, it's real. And Jesus did that. We can shut the Bibles, go home, and try to do that one for the next week. See how you do. And I think we'll do well. I really do. If we go home, just I think we'll do well. And I think it'll change our lives. Give thanks. Now, the next part of verse 19, I see another piece of the sacrifice here. It says, this is my body given for you. I like this one. He said, this is my body given for you. This one relates real well in our modern day culture. Jesus, you know what Jesus gave to his disciples? He gave to the world, if you will. He gave, says it right there, his body. His presence, his body. Don't tell me that you love me. Show me that you love me. Don't tell me your spirit is with me. I want your body. You know, sometimes in the church world, right, Pastor, we get a lot of that one. Mom, I'm with you in spirit. I don't want your spirit. I want your body. Don't be giving me that religious mumble jumble. You got my heart, brother. If I had your heart, I'd have your body. I would have your body. Sacrifice. Jesus gave him his body. He was there. Your body makes a difference. Will you give it as a sacrifice? Sometimes we're willing to give gifts and send money or give nice cards or a phone call. Keep your phone call. Give me your body. I just want to call you and tell you, you're on my heart today. I'm a click. Come visit me. It speaks volumes. I love that about Jesus Christ. He says, this is my body. Isn't it amazing that God, who fills the universe, took on a human form? And then he took that human form and What did he do? Did he build empires? Yeah, man. Did he run for president? Become king? He was king, but what did he do with his body? What did he do? Most important man in the universe. Most important, the busiest man in the universe. He's got to hear every one of our prayers and cries. There's no one busier than God. He took the form of flesh like you and I, and what did he do? I am amazed when I look at the ministry of Jesus. It says he walked around. He had dinner with a lot of people. You ever read that one? Yeah, he had dinner with people. Sat down, talked to the strangers. Like, don't you have anything like really important to do? Like, didn't God have something important to do? What did he do that was important? What do you call it? Like a bio or a resume or something to define his legacy? What did he do? Remember when he was hanging out with people and then the Pharisees were condemning him? He says, I hang out with people and you call me a drunk and a lush. And he said, if I didn't hang out with people, you call me something else. He said, don't make a difference. I can't win with you anyway. Wow, man. Jesus gave his body. He spent time with people. He made people, he didn't make them feel important because that's fake. He showed them that they were important. He showed them. No tokens. Whoever they were. Oh, man, people are important. He gave his body. You know, finally, I guess, I do want to talk about perhaps the greatest phrase in this passage where Jesus says, and you and I repeated today, he said, do this in remembrance of me, right? Yes. When Jesus, after he had the last meal and he gave his body and he gave his lifeblood, you know, after that he said, after that he gave the cup, he gave the bread, he said, how many words is that? Do this in remembrance of me. Six words. Do this in remembrance of me. God's Memorial Day. And this is a question that I'd like to answer for you. But what does it mean to do this in remembrance of me? When Jesus said that, what he was saying is, do likewise. What you see me do, you do. Do this in remembrance of me. Like whatever I'm doing, you do. Remember how I did it and do it the same way. Is there a greater edict in life? I know. Is there a greater edict in life than that? Does anybody care? Thank you, Sister Vanessa. Hey, I do try you once in a while. I'm wondering, like, you know, are they really listening? I don't think they're really listening. Like, for a minute, they just drift. I know that. I can see your eyes. I can see when you drift. I think I'm going to put ketchup on my burger. Do I smell meatloaf? Man, we wander so easy. Oh, is that the best you got, preacher? All right, I just 5 more minutes, okay, guys? And then you live your life with it, all right? Where's that angel? Careful, they're going to get you. No. God bless you. Thank you. When he says, do this in remembrance of me, he says, do likewise. So not only to do what Jesus did, but I want to take it home a little bit, because today we honor sacrifice. We honor the sacrifice of the brave men and women who gave up their life that you and I could have life. Today we honor the soldier. Yes, we do. Today we honor our God, who is our everything. Who made the ultimate sacrifice and he died for the whole world. But maybe we could honor all those who have sacrificed for us. Maybe those who are not with us anymore. Who sacrificed in your life to make you great? Who sacrificed in your life to give you something? To give you love, a friend? Who was it in your life that sacrificed? Who became small so that you could become large? Who did without so you could have something? I really have to bring it home and bring it into the church house and think about sacrifice. I could think of some names, and I'm going to have to name a few because I've got to talk about my mother. I'll talk about your father, my uncle. I'll talk about those who have been a part of this house. Maybe it was your parents. Maybe it was your grandmother or your grandfather. Maybe it was your aunt or your uncle or your teacher. I don't know. Maybe it was your sibling. Can you find somebody in your life who sacrificed? Can everybody find somebody in their life who sacrificed to make sure they had something? Anybody? Can I get a raise of hand on that? Can I get participation? Can we honor their sacrifice? Can we remember them today? Can we say they won't be forgotten? I believe that greatness is built upon sacrifice. I believe what makes you great are those who sacrificed for you. I know what makes any of us great are those who loved us. What makes this church great, what makes this church great are all of you who sacrificed to give something to it. But greatness can't come without sacrifice. Okay? Now, I am absolutely moved by those who have gone before us who have sacrificed. So you ever try to measure that? It's hard to measure. But you ever try to measure that and say, you can't measure the sacrifice that was given. How do you measure the sacrifice that was given? So much was given. And you want to honor that. And I want to just wrap it up with do this in remembrance of me. Okay, everybody? How do you honor that sacrifice that is immeasurable? You do this in remembrance of me. You do likewise. Is anybody mature enough in the house to flip the tables, to turn the tables? Has anybody grown up yet? Anybody ready to give that back? Somebody give you something? Can you give something back? Can you be the sacrifice upon the earth? Can you lay down your life so that greatness can be birthed from it? Can you make this church house great? Can this church house can be great, but greatness can only be built on sacrifice. The greatness of this house depends upon the sacrifice. Depends upon the sacrifice. I look at the elders and the pastors, and they gave everything for this house. Can't you give back? Can't you do something in remembrance of them and do likewise and give your life for what they gave their life for? Amen. Can you do likewise? When Jesus said, "Do this in remembrance of me," he knew what he was asking, but they did not know what he was asking yet. Ultimately, they did. You know what happened to everybody that was at that table? Except for one. You know what happened to everyone at that table? You know. They were his disciples. They all died. They all did likewise. Every one of them laid down their life. You know, John, the beloved, he did it a different way. He laid down his life by living his life for him. John is a beautiful picture. You know, all through his writings, he never talks about himself. Never talks about himself. So he gave his life. He never talks about himself. Always talks about Jesus. When Jesus gives the ultimate sacrifices and he says, "Do this in remembrance of me," I say, how can we honor them? And listen, let us not be children, and let us no longer honor with our lips. Let us no longer say with our lips, "I love you. You got my heart. I'm with you in spirit." May we no longer honor with just lip service. Maybe we can give, I don't know, maybe we could have a meal together. Maybe we can give our bodies. Don't be so stingy with them. You don't know how much you impact this world by showing up, everybody. Amen. You will never know the impact you make by walking into a room. Why don't you give your body? Give thanks. Right? You give thanks for the little that you got, it will overwhelm you and it will be more than enough. But this is my cry and my prayer, perhaps. I say it's my prayer. Maybe it can be your prayer today. Maybe those tables can be turned. And maybe we can become the ones who sacrifice for those around us with absolute intent. We know what we're doing. We know why we're doing it, like our mothers and our fathers and our grandparents before us. May we lay down our lives for something that we believe in, for something greater than ourselves. Amen. For Scripture says, I believe Scripture says, I think we opened with this, greater love. Help me out now. In closing, has no person than to lay down his life for his friends. Amen. God bless you, everybody. Let's see. Why don't you all stand? Praise God. We'll have the praise and worship team come forward. I don't think I want to sing a song just yet. May I ask Pastor Phil to come up, and, you know, if he sang a song while he was talking, you know, we're kind of used to that. But Pastor Phil, I don't know. Why don't you got a mic? Why don't you close us out? And then we'll have them sing.
Amen. There we go. Yeah, that's good, brother. I like how God puts things into perspective, you know, and just the simplicity of it. You know, sometimes we think the sacrifice is just so monumental. It really isn't. It really isn't, church. It's really simpler than we think when we acknowledge God and, of course, give it over to Him. And, you know, it is, I think, obviously fitting, especially on our Communion Sunday. So, you know, God just continues to amaze me with His goodness and His love. I mean, it's just so incredible. And again, that He gives it to us, that we get to live it out. Amen. We get to live it out. That's the sacrifice. That's the sacrifice of a parent to see the joy of the children. Parent ain't all wrapped up in it. There's no greater joy than to see their children living it out. And I believe that's just a picture of our Heavenly Father, just giving it to His children just to live it out, amen, and just to experience His goodness and His kindness. And that's just so incredible. So praise God. Do we have a song to close out with us? All right. What do we got there, Brother Randy? I know who I am. What are we, an F sharp? Give it to me, Keith. No. Let's sing before the Lord. Amen.